Which side? Which side? Can I read? Which side? 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 κλείσω. Λιγάκι.
Θα προσποιήσουμε και προσθέσουμε το βασίλειο του Θεού. Βέβαια θα προσκυνήσουμε και προσπέσουμε Χριστό το Βασιλείο Θεό. Βέβαια θα προσκυνήσουμε και προσπέσουμε αυτό Χριστό το Βασιλείο Θεό εκτιμών. Ευλόγη ψυχή μου τον Κύριον Κύριο, Ευαγγελή της Πόδρα, εξομολόγηση την Ευρωπαίδεια, εμιλήσων αναγολόγων ως φόσο σημάδιων, εκτείνων των ουρανών όσοι δεν είναι ως τη γάζα μου είναι συμπεπορώ αυτού, ότι τι συνέφη την επίμεση αυτού, ο πληθυπαυτών επιμερίδων ανέμων, ο οποίον τους αγγέλους αυτού πνεύματα και τους φετουργούς αυτού πυρός πόλα, ο θεμελιώτη εκείνη επί την ασφάλεια αυτής, ο κλήτης επίσης των αιώνων του όρνους, άβυσος ως μημάτων των πορευόρων αυτού, επί των ωραίων στήσων ύδατα, από επιτιμήσεώς σου φέξονται, από φωνής φροντίσου διγάσωση, αναβαίνουν συνόλοι και καταβαίνουν σε παιδεία στον τόπο με μαθημελίωση σε αυτά. Όρεν εθρώου παραλέσουν το δε πιστέψουν σε καλύψη νημή. Άξι όπως φέρνουν και γάση φάρα έτσι να νομέσουν τον ωραίο αντίκτυπο και έψουν τα ύδατα. Ποτιούς είπαμε τα θρία του αγρού προς δέξον, δέξον τον αρχής δίψαν αυτόν. Επ' αυτά τα πατινά του ουρανού κατησκηνώσει εκ μέσω των πετρών τόση συμφωνή. Ότι ίσον όλοι των απορών αυτού, από καρπού των έργων σου χορταστή στη γη. Ο εξανατέλων χόρτων της κλίνης συγκεκριμένη κλωέν του δελείπων ανθρώπων που εξεγγύν άρτων εκ της γης, και είναι σε φέρει καρδία ανθρώπου. Το δηλαδή είναι πρόσωπο να λέω και άρτους καρδία ανθρώπου σχηρίζει. Χορταστήσουν τα ταξίδια του πεδίου, η κέρδη του λιβάνου άσε φύτευσας. Εκεί σκοφθεί εξουσίωση ο Δοδίου και κατοικείται η γη αυτό. Όλοι τα υψηλά τη ελάφη πέτα κατά τη γη τη επίση η λίγη τη εκπαιδού, ο ήλιο έχουν την τύση αυτού. Ο έδο σκότω και γίνεται το νίξ. Όσα με καλλιτικά έργα σου, Κύριε, πάντα σοφία, επίση. The high mountains are for the king. The cliff is a refuge for the rabbits. He made the moon for seasons, though the sun knows its setting. We established darkness, it was night, wherein all the wild animals of the forest were prowl about. The young lions roar and snatch their prey and seek their food from God. The sun rises and they are gathered together and they shall be put to bed to their dens. Man shall go out to his work and to his labor until evening. O Lord, your work shall be magnified greatly. You made all things in wisdom. The earth was filled with your creation. There is this great and spacious sea, the creeping things are there without number. The living things are there, both small and great. There the ships pass through. There are this dragon formed to play therein. All things wait upon you, that you may give their food in due season.
Oh, Oh. Amen. Jesus, our Savior, our Mighty Lord. Oh. Thank you. Δώσ' μου τον γιο σου,
και έλαβεν αυτόν εκ του κόλπου αυτής. Και αν είναι και ένα αυτόν εκ των υπερών, ενώ αυτός εκάτι το εκεί, και κοίμησε ένα αυτόν εκ της κλίνης αυτού. Και ανεβόησε λιού και είπε, ήμι, Κύριε, ο μάρτης της χείρας, με τίσω εγώ κατοικώ μετά αυτής. Σι εκάκουσαν στο θανατό σε τον γιον αυτής. Και ενεφύσισε το πεδαρίο τρίης και επακελέσατο τον Κύριον και είπε, Κύριε ο Θεός μου, επισταθεί το δι ψυχή του παιδιού τούτου εις αυτό. Και γίνα το ούτρο και αναβόησε και είκοσε Κύριος εν φωνή γλιού και επιστράφει ψυχή του πεδαρίου προς έγκατον αυτού και έζησε. Και έλαβε Ηλία στο πεδάριο και κατήγον αυτό επί του πολλόγου εις τον οίκο και έδωκαν αυτό τη μητρία αυτού και είπεν ηλιού, βλέπε ζει ο γιος σου. Κι είπε γενή προς ηλιού, ειδού τούτο έμπωκα ότι είσαι άνθρωπος του Θεού και είμαι Κυρίου το στόμα της σου αληθινό. The reading is from the third book of the Kingdoms.
Wisdom, let us attend.
It came to pass many days later, in the third year, the word of the Lord came to Elijah, saying, Go and appear to Ahab, and I will send rain on the earth. When Ahab saw Elijah, Ahab said to him, Are you the one who is troubling Israel? Elijah answered, I have not troubled Israel, but rather you and the house of your father, in that you forsook the Lord your God, and followed after the Baals. Now therefore, send and gather all Israel to me on Mount Carmel, the 450 prophets of Shem, and the 400 prophets of the sacred groves who eat at Jezebel's table. So Ahab went back to Israel and gathered all the prophets on Mount Carmel. Then Elijah came near to all of them and said, How long will you be undecided between two opinions? If the Lord is God, follow him. But if Baal, follow him. But the people did not answer. And then Elijah said to the people, I alone remain as a prophet of the Lord, but there are 450 men or prophets of Baal, and 400 prophets of the sacred groves. Let them give us two oxen, then let them choose one bull for themselves to be cut to pieces and laid on the wood. But they shall not light a fire under it. I will prepare the other bull and lay it on the wood, and I will not light a fire under it. Then you will call loudly on the name of your gods, and I will call on the name of the Lord my God. So it shall come to pass that the God who answers by fire, he is God. So all the people answered and said, The word you have spoken is good. Choose one calf for yourselves and prepare it, for there are many of you. Then call on the name of your God, but do not put fire on the wood under it. So they took a calf and prepared it, and called on the name of Baal from morning until noon, saying, Hear us, O Baal, hear us. But there was no voice, for no one answered. And they ran about the altar that they had made. Then it came to pass at noon that Elijah the Tishbite mocked them and said, Cry out with a loud voice, for he is a God, for either he is away meditating, or he is too busy, or preoccupied with other business. Perhaps he is sleeping and has need to be awakened from his nap. So they cried aloud and prophesied until early evening, until the appointed time to offer the evening sacrifice. But even still, there was no voice. Finally, Elijah the Tishbite spoke to the prophets of the idols, saying, Now remove yourselves from this place, for I will offer my whole burnt offering. And they turned away and departed. Then Elijah said to the people, Come near me. So all the people came near to him. Elijah took 12 stones according to the number of the tribes of Israel, for the Lord said, Israel shall be your name. And then he built an altar of the stones in the name of the Lord, and he repaired the altar of sacrifice that was scattered about, and around the altar he made a fire of holding 2 measures of seed. He piled the firewood on the altar he had made, divided the whole burnt offering, laid on the firewood, laid it in order on the altar. Then he said, bring me 4 pots of water, and pour it on the whole burnt offering, and pour it on the unlit firewood. They did so. Again Elijah said, do it a second time. So they did it again. And again he said, do it a third time. So they did it a third time. And the water ran all about the altar, and even the furrow became filled with water. After this, Elijah cried out to heaven and said, O Lord God of Abraham, Isaac, and Israel, answer me, O Lord, answer me this day with fire, and let this people know you are the God of Israel, and I am your servant. And for your sake I do all these works. Hear me, O Lord, hear me with fire, and let these people know you are the Lord God, so as to turn the heart of these people back. Then fire fell from the Lord out of heaven and consumed the whole burnt offering, the firewood, and the water in the furrow. The fire also licked up the stones of the soil. So all the people fell on their faces and they said, truly the Lord is God, he is God. Elijah then said to the people, seize the prophets of Baal, let no one of them escape. So they seized them, and Elijah brought them down to the brook of Kishon, where he slaughtered them. After this, Elijah said to Ahab, there is a sound of rain. Make ready your chariot and get down from here before the rain ever comes. But Elijah went up to the top of Carmel, where he bowed down on the ground and put his face between his knees. Thus it came to pass that the sky darkened with black clouds and wind, and there was a heavy downpour of rain. And Ahab mourned and went to Jezreel. Now Ahab told Jezebel, his wife, everything Elijah did. Then Jezebel sent to Elijah, saying, if you are Elijah, and I this Jezebel, may God do so to me more also, if at his hour tomorrow I do not make your life like the life of one of them that you slaughtered. Elijah was fearful, and he arose and ran for his life. He came to Beersheba of Judah, where he left his servant. But Elijah himself went a day's journey to the wilderness and came and sat under a juniper tree. Then he lay down and slept under a tree. Unexpectedly, someone touched him and said to him, arise and eat. Then Elijah looked, and there by his head was a cake made of wheat and a jar of water. So he ate and drank and lay down again. Again the angel of the Lord came back a second time, touched him and said, arise and eat, because the journey is a great many days for you. So he arose, ate and drank, and he went with the strength of that food 40 days and 40 nights, as far as Mount Horeb. Then he went into a cave and rested. The word of the Lord came to him and said to him, Elijah, what are you doing here? And Elijah said, I have been very zealous for the Lord Almighty, since the children of Israel have forsaken you. They tore down your altars and killed your prophets with the sword. I alone am left, and they seek to take my life. Then the Lord said to him, go and return on your way to the desert of Damascus, and you shall anoint Elisha, the son of Shaphat of Abel, Elohim, as a prophet in your place. Basilion, Triton, Tolan, Malkos,
Sophia, Broskomen.
Εγένε το ημέρα και δίσκει λιούν τον Λεσέ, Ιόν, Σαχάν, και αυτός πήρε 3 έκδοση και απίθυνε λίγο επ' αυτόν και επέλειψε τη μεγωτήνα αυτού επ' αυτόν και κατέληπεν η Λυσέο τους Βόας και έβλεμεν ο πίσω ηλίου και λειτουργεί αυτό και γίνεται το ανάγκη των κύριων ηλιού εν σεισμό όσοι στον ουρανό και πολλέθη ηλιού και ελισέ εν καλκάλης. Κι είπεν ηλία στο ελισέ κάθονται εν τάφα ότι Κύριος απέσταται με έως ουρδάνο. Κι είπεν ελισέ ζει Κύριος και ζει ψυχή σου ή καταλήψωσε. Και πορεύθησαν αμφότινοι και πεντήκοντα άντρας από τον Υιόν των προφητών ήρθον και έστησαν εξ εναντίος παπλώθεν αμφότινοι και έστησαν εκ τον Ορδάνη. Και έλαβε μιλία στην μιλωτήν αυτού και ήλισε αυτήν και πάλι ξέναν αυτή τα ύδατα και διαλέτη του είδωρ έντεν και έντεν και διέβησαν αμφότινοι διαξηράς. Και γένετο ως δίωθεν είπε Ηλίας το Ελισέ, έκλεισο μη την πίσω σοι, πριν αναλευθύνε με από σου. Κι είπε Ελισέ, κινηθεί το δί το πνεύμα του Ελισή της ως ερμέ. Κι είπε Ηλίας εσπίρμας το ετήσαστε, πλην εάν είδης με αναδαμόμενο από σου, έστεση ούτως εάν δεν μη, είδης που είναι γέννητο και γέννητο αυτό περιωμένων και λαλούρτων και ειδού άλμα πληρός και ήπη πληρός και διεχώρησαν αναμέσων αμφωτέρων και ενελήφθην ηλίας εν σεισμό ως εις τον ουρανό και λυσέ εώρα και αυτός εγώ πάτε πάτερ άλμα Ισραήλ και πέρσου αυτού κι ουκ είδεν αυτόν ουκ έτεινε και κράτησεν εσέ το ημάν τη ματρίου αυτού και διέλυξεν αυτό εις δύο. Κανέλητο την γιορτήν ηλού ηλισέ και πισούσαν επάνω τον αυτού και επέστρεψε ηλισέ και έσκεπτε το χείλος του Ιορδάνου και έλαβε ηλισέ την γιορτήν ηλού την πισούσαν επάνω τον αυτού και πάτεξε τα ύδατα και ουδι ελέγχθη. Κι είπεν Ηλισέ, πού διέστην ο Θεός ηλιού αγχώ. Κι ούτως εκάταξε τα ύδατα έκτευτε αρώ. Και διελεύθη τα ύδατα και διουθέθη αμαξιράς.
Είπομε πάνω σε ξόλις κλειδίς και ξόλις διανύες μόνοι. Είπομε.
Υπότιτλοι AUTHORWAVE.
το απευθεχομένο του παρασού μεγάλο και πλούσιο ενεός.
Κυελέξον, κυελέξον, κυελέξον.
Ότι ελεημόν και θεάνθρωπος Θεός Πάτης, εσύ τη δόξαν αναπέμπομεν, το Πατρί και το Υιό και το Άγιο Πνεύμα την ίδια ή και εις τους αιώνας των αιώνων.
Καταξίωσον Κύριε τη εσπέρα τάχτη αμαρτήτως φυλαχθήνε ημάς. Ευλογητός η Κύριε ο Θεός και Πατέρων ημών και νεκρών και ενδόξασμένων το όνομά Σου εις τους αιώνας. Αμήν. Γέννητο Κύριε το ελαιό Σου εφημάς κατάπλου πείσαμεν επί σένα. Ευλογητός η Κύριε την αψώνει με τα δικαιώματά Σου, ευλογητός η Δέσποτα συνεπισών με τα δικαιώματά Σου, ευλογητός η Άγια φόρησών με τις δικαιωμασίες Σου, Κύριε το ελαιό Σου εις τον αιώνα, τα έργα των χειρών Σου μη παρήθεις. Συ πρέπει έννο, συ πρέπει ύμνο, συ δόξα πρέπει, το Πατρί και το Υιό και το Άγιο Πνεύμα, την ίδια έγκαι στους μόνους μόνο να μην παλαιόν κύπας της ίδιου θεανσύν. Blessed are you, our Lord, God of our fathers. I praise and glorify your name to the ages. Amen. O Lord, let your mercy be upon us, for we have set our hope in you. Blessed are you, Lord, teach me your commandments. Blessed are you, Master, grant me understanding of your commandments. Blessed are you, Holy One, enlighten me with your commandments. Lord, your mercy is forever. Do not despise the work of your hands. To you is due praise, to you is due song, to you is due glory, to the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and unto the ages of ages.
Πληρώσομεν την εσπερινή δέση ημών των Κυρίων.
Κύριε, ελέησον.
Αναβούς όσον ελέησον και διαφύλαξον ημάς ο Θεός της η χάρη.
Κύριε, ελέησον.
Την εσπέραν πάσαν τελείαν Αγίαν ειρηνική και αναμάρτητον παρά του Κυρίου ετησόμεθα.
Αργάσκον Κύριε.
Άγγελον ειρήνης πιστών οδηγών, φύλακα των ψυχών και των σωμάτων ημών παρά του Κυρίου ετησόμεθα.
Αργάσκον Κύριε.
Συγνώμη και άφεση των αμαρτιών και των πλημελημάτων ημών παρά του Κυρίου ετησόμεθα.
Αργάσκον Κύριε.
Παρά του Κυρίου ετησόμεθα.
Δόξον Κύριε.
Τον υπόλοιπο χρόνο της ζωής ημών εν ειρήνη και μετανοία εκτελέσε. Παρά του Κυρίου ετησόμεθα.
Δόξον Κύριε.
Χριστιανά τα τέλη της ζωής ημών ανώδυνα ανεπαίσθητα. Απολογία την επί του φοβερού βήματος του Χριστού ετησόμεθα.
Παράσον Κύριε.
Της Παναγίας ακράντου υπερευλογημένης εν δόξου δεσποίνης ημών Θεοτόκου και αϊπαρθένου Μαρίας με τα πάντων των Αγίων μνημονεύσαντες εαυτούς και αλλήλους πάσαν την ζωή ημών, Χριστό το Θεό παραθώμεθα. Ότι αγαθός και φιλάνθρωπος Θεός υπάρχεις και εσύ την δόξα να αναπέμπομαι, το Πατρί και το Υιό και το Άγιο Πνεύμα την ίν και αΐ και εις τους αιώνας των αιώνων.
Αμήν.
Εκείνη πάση
το πνεύμα της Σου.
Τα πολλά θυμών των Κυρίων κλείνομεν. Με Με δόξεν όνομα των τέκνων των Πάρας Αναστασίας Εκατέρνης Θεία και Σποτινής Μαρίνης Παρασκευής και Ειρήνης των Οσίων και Θεοπών Πατρέμων το Αγία Δόξου Προφήτου Θεσβήτου ού και την επιτελούμε και πάντων σου των Αγίων. Δίκαιτε ο Πνεύσε, επάξωσε τριμόνο εκείς πάντων των περάπτων της γης και των θαλάσσιων μακρά και ήλθε ο ασκήρεντας πρώτης ημών και ευαΐσαι ημάς. Επρόεδρο πίσω και δέησιν ημών, δώρησιν μη κράτη παρά το μάτι ημών, σκέπωσιν μας και την περίβον σου, αποδείξω πάντα έκτρων και πολέμιων, ειρήνευσε λοιπόν τη ζωή και του κόσμου σου, το στουμάσαι καθώς και πλάτρωπος και ελεήμων Θεό.
Oh, yeah. αρχικός ηλεβάνεσαι τους πυμενότους πανηγυρίσαι τη ανήμην αυτού ούτες πρεσβείες διαφύλαξον τον λαόν σου Χριστέωτε ως ημών από πάθης παντίας του τον Ιηρού ανεμόφυγον.
Διάθεσαι τον Χριστό μου και τις προφήτες μου και τον ειδηθέσαστε.
Παρανομίσαν τα φίλεξα σαν αυτά και
ύλη των προφήτων της Εκκλησίας. Εσείς ξέρετε την διήγηση καλύτερα από μένα, αλλά δεν μπορεί παρά να μας αγγίξει η σημερινή εορτή στην σημερινή εποχή. Σκεφτόμαστε για την άσκηση του κρυφτού ηλιού, τη μολυστή τροφή του, εκεί που ζούσε στα βουνά, την τομερή άσκηση που έκανε στον εαυτό του. Και όλα αυτά όχι μόνο εκτιμούν την τρυφερότητα που είχε για τον Θεό μας, αλλά ήταν σαν μια ζωντανή μαρτυρία για το καθεστώς της εποχής τότε. Οι άνθρωποι είχαν αλλάξει την πίστη τους. Αντί να λατρεύουν τον Θεό, λάτρευαν τα είδωλα. Μιλάω για τον βασιλέα Αχάβ και την γυναίκα του, την Ιεζάβελ. Εδώ τους και όλοι οι κάτοικοι τους, αντί να προσκυνούν τον Θεό, προσκύνησαν τα είδωλα, δηλαδή τα παθήματά τους. Και έρχεται η παρουσία του κρυφτού ηλιού σε αυτή την εποχή. Μια εποχή που ίσως ομοιάζει με τη σημερινή, που οι ρίζες, οι δικές μας είναι χριστιανικές, όπως και στην χώρα που ζούμε. Τα παραδείγματα λοιπόν από την εξουσία και από την διοίκηση σε κάθε κατεύθυνση. Εν πάση περιπτώσει έρχονται αυτές οι εορτές ώστε να μας ξυπνήσουν, λίγο να μας αφυπνήσουν. Και θα πάρω την προσοχή σας σε τρία αξιόσημα σημειώματα. Σε τρία γεγονότα από την ζωή του προφήτη Ηλιού. Ζήτησε να αντικρίσει τον Θεό. Ζήτησε να δει τον Χριστό. Και ζητούσε από τον κόσμο μέσα να βρει τον Χριστό, τον Θεό, στον αέρα, στα βουνά, στην φύση, στις συνθήκες της ζωής. Τελικά, παρουσιάστηκε ο Θεός σαν μικρό αέρα. Και εκεί κατάλαβε ότι η παρουσία του Θεού δεν είναι έξω, δεν είναι σαν αντικείμενο, δεν είναι στην εξουσία, δεν είναι στα κάτω θώματα, αλλά είναι στην καλύνη της ψυχής. Και παίρνουμε μηνύματα να μην κοιτάμε για τον Θεό έξω, να μην κοιτάμε για την χαρά μας, την ευφροσύνη μας, σε γεγονότα έξω από τον ελεγχό μας. Αλλά ο Χριστός υπάρχει μέσα μας. Εκεί είναι ο αληθινός Θεός. Να μην περιμένουμε από πολλές ομιλίες και άλλα πράγματα με εξωτερική εμφάνιση, αλλά να ακούσουμε τη φωνή της συνεδρίσεώς μας και πίστευσέ μου, εκεί είναι η φωνή του Θεού. Δεύτερον, ήταν έναν αγωνισμό που έκανε ο προφήτης Ηλιού με τους ιερείς της Εσχήνης, οι ηγέτες των θρησκευμάτων έξω από τον αληθινό Θεό, που είχαν δύο βόμους, τους ξέρουμε την ιστορία. Ο ένας βόμος ήταν με ξύλα, ξέρα ξύλα, και ο δεύτερος βόμος του προφήτου Ηλιού ήταν πρεγμένο, με πρεγμένα ξύλα. Οι ιδωλάτρες κάλεσαν τον Θεό τους, τίποτα δεν έγινε. Ο προφήτης Ηλιού με την δική του ηγεσία μια φορά κάλεσε και ήρθε φωτιά και κατέστρεψε τα ξύλα που ήταν πρεγμένα. Τι μπορούμε να πάρουμε από αυτή την διήγηση? Αγαπητοί αδελφοί, ο βόμβας είναι η ψυχή μας και τα ποτισμένα ξύλα είναι οι αμαρτίες μας, οι αδυναμίες μας. Και εκεί που νομίζουμε ότι δεν έχουμε ελπίδα, όταν καλούμε τον Χριστό, τον Θεό, έρχεται, όχι μόνο στέλνει φωτιά, αλλά στέλνει το Άγιο Πνεύμα, όπως έκανε και σήμερα στην Λειτουργία, και έστειλε το Άγιο Πνεύμα και έγινε η μεταβολή του άρτου και του ύμου στο τίμιο σώμα και αίμα του Χριστού μας. Αλλά να έρθει το Άγιο Πνεύμα, πρέπει και εμείς να ποτίσουμε όχι με αμαρτίες, αλλά με τα κλάματά μας, με τη μετάνοια μας, και θα έρθει ο Χριστός. Το τρίτο γεγονός, αγαπητοί αδελφοί, είναι το εξής. Πώς έφυγε ο προφήτης Ηλίου από αυτόν τον κόσμο? Είδαμε ότι φωτιά, πυρός, άρμα τον πήγε στον ουρανό. Και εμείς όταν ζούμε μέσα στο πνεύμα της Εκκλησίας, μας θυσιάζει η χάρη του Θεού. Και ενώ ζούμε, δεν ζούμε σε αυτόν τον κόσμο, αλλά ζούμε μέσα στην αιώνια βασιλεία των ουρανών. Έχω μια τελευταία παράκληση. Η παράκληση της προσευχής που ακούσετε και αυτό σήμερα. Μία χείρα είχε ένα παιδί που πέθανε. Τον παρέδωσε στον προφήτη και ο προφήτης με την εκκλησία του, με την προσευχή του δηλαδή, τον έδωσε ζωή. Και με φέρνει στο σκεπτικό πόσο σπουδαίο είναι εμείς οι χριστιανοί να προσεύχεται ο ένας σε τον άλλον. Όχι απλώς να δίνουμε το όνομά μας στους ιερείς μας και καλά κάνουμε. Όχι απλώς να πούμε μια ευχή έτσι τυπικά για τον συνάνθρωπό μας, αλλά με πόνο καρδιάς, με κλάματα αν χρειαστεί, και γονατισμός να ευχόμαστε για τους συνανθρώπους μας. Ξέρετε, είναι πιο εύκολα να προσευχόμαστε για τους άλλους παρά για τον εαυτό μας. Οπότε, αν πετύχουμε στην προσευχή για τον συνάνθρωπό μας, θα πετύχουμε και με την δική μας προσευχή. Ήρθε η εποχή να το ρίξουμε όλοι στην προσευχή, με όποιον τρόπο μπορούμε, όχι με χρόνο, αλλά με ειλικρίνεια, με αυταπάρνηση, με ποιότητα, με ταπείνωση. Και θα στέλνει ο Θεός με τον δικό του τρόπο το άρμα, το Άγιο Πνεύμα, να μας υψώσει όλους, ώστε ενώ ζούμε εδώ, το πολίτευμά μας θα είναι στην Βασιλεία των Ουρανών. Τι επιγράφει τη Ρέμι Σέλβε, τη Φίσα, τη Πρόφετ Αγάιας. He needs no introduction. He wrote no words, and yet he's so glorious and marvelous. The hymns that we've heard today refer to him as the pillar of all prophets. How did this prophet who lived in the 9th century before Christ, 500 years before philosophy, how did this prophet come to teach us true philosophy? I want to recount three events from his life. And the first is his desire to see God. He had a genuine desire to find God. And for him it was beyond question that God exists. And I'm sure that occurs to all of us. The question that he wanted to know is, where does God exist?
He went to the mountains. He went to the desert. He went to the seas. But a slight breeze passed him. And there it was told to him that that's where God exists. In other words, God exists in our lives in subtle encounters that we have in every moment of our lives. He exists in our conscience. He speaks to us. We do not need to look for God outside of His presence, and His presence is within us. Prophet Elias lived an ascetic. As an ascetic, in extreme humility. And that was more so, not only as a result of his love for God and the way he expressed that, but also as a reaction to the demise of the world that he lived in. King Ahab and Queen Jezebel were once believers, were once God-fearers, were once profound children of God, but they and their constituents and the citizens that they ruled over replaced the worship of the true God for the worship of a foreign, false, pagan God. That simply meant our worship of the very self. Whatever passion, whatever weakness, whatever indulgence one had, that was not fought against or challenged, but rather accepted and glorified and proclaimed and established as a given and forced upon everyone else. To combat this, Elijah called the priest of Baal, that he referred to as the priest of shame, another priest, and set up two altars. We know the story, a dry altar for the false priests they set up themselves, and he had his altar set up with the same amount of wood, but his altar was drenched in water. And the understanding was, who has the true God? The false prophets who worship Baal, in other words, themselves, idolatry, or the true God of Prophet Elias, which was once the God of the faithful then, of the people then? Lo and behold, the prophets, the priests of Baal, call upon their God and nothing happens. In fact, it was excruciating the way they would. They would not only yell, but they would actually cut themselves and in much pain call upon their God and nothing would happen. A simple call though from the prophet Elias called upon the fire of God. God came down and consumed the wood that was drenched. And it teaches us what is possible in our lives, and that is to become an all-consuming fire. And this leads me to the third event, and that is Prophet Elias' ending. A chariot came, a fiery chariot came, and elevated him to heaven. In the life of the church, we don't simply have fire coming down on us during worship and in our relationship with God. We have the very Holy Spirit Himself, and that is an all-consuming fire. And the more we are tuned to it, the more we want to be separated by the ways of the world. I have a humble request, which also comes from today's readings. It's a final request, but I think most important. In the days of Prophet Elias, there was a widow who had a son. And she asked Prophet Elias to help her with him, this son. This son actually died. And then she complains to the Prophet, Why has my child died? The prophet actually took the child, embraced it, and prayed for it sincerely. and a child came back to life. Rather than look at the ways that God reveals himself to us in the Old Testament, called the economy of salvation, more important for us when we read the scripture, equally true to the accuracy of the events, is what is being told to us. And I believe the time has come that our prayer towards each other becomes more fervent. It's not enough just to simply remember someone in our prayers, or even give a name to a priest to read out, "All this is special and good and holy and blessed." But we need to, with all our hearts, pray for each other, specifically and collectively. And Christ our God will give us all life. What awaits us is for the Holy Spirit to come and elevate us all. Not because we want to separate from the world. When we talk about separation in this way, we rather mean from our sins. But we want to be so attached to the world that we want to sanctify it through the presence of Christ, and this is made possible. Dear beloved, our prayers are needed. It is easier to pray for each other than it is for our very own selves. If we want our own personal prayers to be effective, a good sign is in the way that we are effectively able to pray for each other. We don't have King Ahab and Queen Jezebel here, but we have the same passions and the same desires that they do. Let us pray for them. In other words, for each other, so that our elevation is not only eminent, but so that we are experiencing it at every single moment of our lives. Amen. Nina Police, on the most of this, for that I can be with you. For the evil of the news of the news, why do you must have a και δόξα να ούσου Ισραήλ.
Εις πολλά είναι η Δέσποτα.
Holy God, Holy Mighty, Holy Mother, have mercy on us. Holy God, Holy Mighty, Holy Mother, have mercy on us. Holy God, Holy Mighty, Holy Mother, have mercy on us. Glory to the Father, to the Son, and the Holy Spirit, both now and ever, and to the age of the least. Amen. All the Holy Trinity, have mercy on us, Lord. Forgive our sins. Master, pardon our transgressions. Holy One, visit and heal our infirmities, your name's sake. Lord have mercy, Lord have mercy, Lord have mercy. Glory to the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit, both now and ever, and to the ages of ages. Amen.
Please rest assured that we pray regularly
for the South Australian Parliament, but also the current government of which you are its head. Your example here, your presence here, speaks words that perhaps never have been written in history. And I pray that what you are doing today happens across the whole world. Your presence teaches us that our participation expresses our desire to become something greater. May these noble desires that you have be fulfilled in you and also in the rest of us. We thank you and we sincerely salute your presence this evening. Αγαπητοί αδελφοί, έχουμε εδώ τους δύο συνάδελφους. Και τι μπορεί να τους ονομάσει ένας άνθρωπος. Εκτιμάμε πάρα πολύ την ευλάβειά τους. Κατά σύμπτωση είμαστε στον υγρό ναό του προφήτου Λιού. Ξέρετε τι ζήτησε ο μικρότερος από τον μεγαλύτερο, ο Ελισσαίος από τον Ηλία, προτού να πεθάνει ο Ηλίας. Ζήτησε ο μικρότερος να με, από τον μεγαλύτερο, από τον Ηλία, να πάρει δύο φορές την χάρη του. Ο μεγαλύτερος είχε την ταπείνωση να πει αυτό, δεν μπορώ, δεν είναι σε μένα. Αλλά αν συμβεί κάτι, αν θα τα γνωρίζονται όπως τα επιθυμούμε, θα έρθει η διπλή χάρη. Και όταν ζούμε μια αισθητική στιγμή που ο γέροντας στον τέκνο του ήδη έχει δώσει την διπλή χάρη. Γι' αυτό δοξάζουμε τον Θεό. Ο πατήρ Μιχαήλ είναι παιδί της Εκκλησίας και είμαι και θέματι από την Αδελαίδα. Ίσως είναι το πιο πολύτιμο δώρο που έχει να προσφέρει η νέα γενιά στην Εκκλησία μας. Ο Θεός έχει το δικό του μέτρο. Αλλά όλοι μας έχουμε μια ιδέα. Να τον αγαπήσουμε, να τον υψώσουμε, να τον κρατούμε με την προσευχή μας και να τον ενθουσιαζόμαστε με την χριστοκεντρική ζωή μας και στην υπακοή ένα Υιού Πνεύματι και αφοσίωσή μας στην Εκκλησία και στο θέλημα του Θεού. Ο πατήρ δεν φεύγει, απρόσκατα θα κουραστεί περισσότερο. Γιατί η μέρη του δεν θα είναι διοικητικά. Θα είναι να προσεύχεται για μας. Από τον πατήρ θα δώσει, θα ρωτήσει λόγο ο Θεός. Τι έκανε με τα νέα βλαστάρια που υπάρχουν στην Ιπομπική Εκκλησία. Όπως και ο πατήρ και οι άλλοι γέροντες παρών και που αποσιάζουν, αυτή θα είναι η αποστολή τους. Εμείς θα τους θυμάμαι, θα τους δείχνουμε απόλυτο σεβασμό και αγάπη και εύχομαι αυτό το παράδειγμα που βλέπουμε εδώ να συνεχιστεί. Με την βοήθεια του Θεού θα πετύχει πολύ ο πατήρ Μιχαήλ. Έχει πολλά χαρίσματα, πάρα πολλά, τα γνωρίζετε, αλλά τα περισσότερα τα κρατάει κρυμμένα για Αυτόν και για τον Θεό. Οπότε όταν τον αξιώσει ο Θεός να πάει στον Παράδεισο, να έχει κάτι να τον περιμένει εκεί και να δώσει πίσω εδώ στην γη. Το ίδιο ισχύει για τον πατήρ Σταύρο, θεοφοβούμενος, προσεκτικός, τυπικός. Δεν πάβει να αγωνίζεται. Σήμερα βλέπουμε χαρά, γιατί το Άγιο Πνεύμα εκπληρώνει εκεί που νομίζουμε ότι υπήρχε αδιέξοδο. Πάει καλά η Εκκλησία μας. Και εφόσον θα καλά, αυτό σημαίνει ότι θα μπορεί και να πάει καλύτερα. Αναμένουμε με πολύ χαρά την καποφορία τους. Dear brother, it is a deep, distinct joy as well to introduce Father Michael, your new parish priest, a worthy successor of his father. It's fitting that our prophet Elias' day this takes place. And it recalls one of the last conversations that Prophet Elias had with his disciple Elisha. Personified in Elisha's father Michael, and the personification of Prophet Elias' father Stavros. Knowing that Elijah was to leave the world, Elisha asks from his spiritual mentor, "Can I please have double the grace that you have?" Elias responds with much humility, "That is impossible for me to answer." He says this, of course, in his own words. But if certain events take place, it will happen. We can clearly say, as a result of the self-offering love and sacrifice of Father Stavros, as every father has towards their son, we can all see that Father Michael has received double the grace and a lot more. Not only is it a profound gift from his father, a deposit, an inheritance, but as a result of being touched by the grace and presence of God. Father Stavros does not stop being a priest. Rather, he has more opportunities to be sanctified. Administration of the renewal cease so that he can spend more time praying for the local church. We call upon him and our other elderly clergy who are in service and or not to not forsake us in their prayers. Our debt towards them will be seen in the way that we show them unconditional love and respect. I have every reason to believe that the church in Adelaide will succeed. But that which is good, because of its success, is only this way because there is much need for things to be better. Please welcome Father Michael into the congregation. Show him love, elevate him with your prayers. Inspire him through your example, your commitment to Christ, and your obedience to the presence of God in the life of the church. They are both worthy. If I can ask your wonderful chanters, by way of ending, if you can sing Axios, please come and pray a wonderful praise.
Axios,
due to COVID, restrictions. And of course, we have been obeying as much as we can. What we're going to do is get everybody, θα σας παρακαλέσω να καθίσετε στη θέση σας και θα έρθει το Συμβούλιο. The members of the Συμβούλιο and other volunteers will come to get you up row by row. Θα σας σηκώσουν σειρά με σειρά να έρθετε να πάρετε τον Θεοφιλέστατο, τον Άρτο. You will be able to receive the Holy Artos from His Grace, row by row. Σας παρακαλώ την υπομονή σας και την και ησυχία και σας ευχαριστώ πάρα πολύ. Ίσως δεν είναι κατάλληλη ώρα, δεν ξέρω αν θέλετε να πείτε τίποτα. Πάτε Σταύρο, ίσως αύριο, δεν ξέρω. Perhaps it might be an opportunity to of course recognize especially the presence of the Premier of South Australia, Sir Stephen Marshall. And of course, Adrian Christopoulos from SAMIAC, thank you very much for being with us. And of course, the Archon Epicon of the Ecumenical Patriarchate and the Honorary President of our community and parish here, Mr. John Christopoulos, and everybody here, all our parishioners. I won't say much other than today has been a very difficult day for me, because I've left a parish that I served for 8 years in the morning, and of course another worthy person, priest, who is here today, Father Christopoulos, has taken over that parish. And to come here today and to hear these words, not only from the hymns that we hear today and the readings, but also the words of His Grace, and how you made your grace that comparison between Elias and Elisha with myself and my father has really touched me. And I guess I ask something a bit more greedy than that. I wish it'd be three times the grace, to have three times the grace. But again, if it's meant to be the will of God and for certain events to happen, that will happen. All I would like to say to you is that Prophet Elias has been a very big saint in our family before Pater Stavro became a priest, before he knew that Norwood existed as a parish in Sydney. He prayed at the cave of Saint Prophet Elias at Springwood, the monastery of Saint George, and he prayed there for many, many hours with a lot of tears. And a few months later, he was told that he was going to go to Norwood at a parish called Prophet Elias. And years later, rather a few months after that, I was born, unfortunately, for my family. And I was born on the day that the parish of Prophet Elias celebrated its 25th anniversary. And His Eminence, the late Archbishop Stylianos, was actually in Adelaide that evening and was one of the first to hear of the great news of my birth. Sort of a bit odd saying that. But I guess what I'm trying to say is I was born into this parish, into this community, literally. And for whatever reason, God has His ways. And unfortunately for you, I'm back. But fortunately for me, I am back because I'm back home. My home was St. Andrews. It's still going to be home for me. Because you can imagine 8 years of work together with my presbytera, who without her we cannot do what we do. That's why her name is presbytera. It's the feminine noun for the priest's wife, which means presbyter, which is priest. And therefore, she has an equal role. And when I was ordained here, I was ordained a deacon. I was married here before that. I was baptized here, married, ordained deacon, ordained priest. And today, on Prophet Elias Day, out of all days, I have been appointed on the Vespers. So, Prophet Elias is with us and will always be with us as a family and me personally. I just wanted to share something very personal with you, just to let you know that the God of Elias is real, and that I'm here as a servant of God, the least, the most unworthy. But your presence and your assistance on our road to salvation is something that is very important and unique, and that's what really drives us as Christians. So I would like this to be an invitation for all of us to continue to consolidate what has already been established. Thank you very much. Dina Fisos. Thank you very much for your presence.
I pray to take too long from your precious time, dear brethren. Your Grace, dear Premier of South Australia, Stephen Marshall, Mr. Jerry Sogers, Mr. Christopoulos, Andy, dear all, in this last moment, as the Reverend Father in charge of this place, community, and parish, prefer us, Lord, in instance others, before anyone else, I would humbly like to express my warmest heartfelt thank you to our true God for all the miraculous signs He has revealed to me, His unworthy servant, during my ministry. I owe my gratitude and many thanks to the former Archbishop of Australia, Strianos Patrinakis, for his great honour towards me to bestow upon me on the occasion of my ordination to the first and second rank priesthood. I'm ever grateful that he sent me to serve God in his blessed parish of Norwood and to attend the flock of our Holy Archdiocese. His example, his prudence, and the directness of his words were a great help during my ministry. May the Holy God rest among the saints. I also extend my many thanks and gratitude to our spiritual shepherd, His Eminence, the Archbishop of Australia, Macarius. I had the great honour of welcoming and getting to know His Holiness, who arrived at the Holy Cathedral of the Annunciation in Redfern, Sydney, on the occasion of his enthronement. I especially appreciate his wisdom, prudence, pastoral interest, but also the clarity of action which distinguishes him, and the wisdom he has illustrated in the spiritual interests of his community parish. The current appointment of Father Michael Saramidis to the position of your new leading spiritual father from today is due solely to the spiritual prudence of His Eminence, the Archbishop of Australia, Macarius. For this reason, I thank him on your behalf, but also feel free to send him your personal thanks. The God, same virtues of your new Archbishop are guarantees, but also reasons essential for the harmonious navigation of the sheep of Holy Archdiocese here in Australia. Even the ordination of the Most Reverend Bishop of Sinope, Siron, as well as his appointment to South Australia, showed the special interest of His Eminence towards us in our state. Warm thanks to the Most Reverend Bishops of Sinope, Siron. We have excellent cooperation, who certainly contribute to the current positive result of the appointment of Father Michael Saramidis to this community. Also, warm thanks must go to the former Bishop Paul of Christian Emperor, Joseph of Arianzos, and Elvira Conesso, Seraphim of Christian Emperors, and Alperios, Nicandros of Doriano, here in Borios, for their Christ collaboration. Extra thanks to the presidents and to all past and present members of the respective executive committees, the directors, the ladies, the doctors, all communities and the subcommittees, the volunteers, the donors and benefactors, the youth and the altar boys. At the same time, I congratulate the political leaders of South Australia, and in particular the current government by the leadership of the Honourable Stephen Marshall, on the generous funding for our learning centre, which was the fulfilment of my dream and my original plan for this blessed community and parish. Finally, I cannot find suitable or adequate words to sufficiently thank the faithful and pious people of this community and parish for Pharaoh's Lord and Esther Sobers, my dear ones. We pray together, we applaud, we consoled each other for 37 years, and we were saddened. We cooperated and fought together, sharing joys and sorrows. But in the end, the Lord helped us win. The words we have achieved over nearly 37 years speak to this victory. Today I praise God that we are in a happy position to share the divine works of God and pray from the bottom of my heart that the Lord will reciprocate to each of us according to his God's pleasing intentions. Last but not least, a word about Presbyter, my family and extended family. The success of the great work that has been achieved would not have been possible had it not been for the sacrifices. I would like to give my heartfelt thanks to Presbyter, my children and my esteemed families, my grandchildren, my brothers and all my relatives for their sacrifices, their contributions for the success of this great work. Without them, it would have been impossible to achieve the exceptional outcomes. As for me, my dear brethren, the only thing that I ask from you and beg you on my knees is to forgive me and to direct your prayers towards the true God for me, his unworthy servant, so that he may show me mercy in the last day of judgment. Concrete, I wish from the bottom of my heart, God may grant us salvation in his kingdom. Now, because I take too much on of this, I go with the great one. But tomorrow, I'm just in Greek. So we're going more to understand how I feel and how thankful I am in order to express to you that everything has been done is not for me. I'm only just a tool of God, and also am here, put me in the right spot, so I was able to achieve everything we have done together. With you, without you, I won't be able to do anything. So here on the heart of this community, at this moment, as in this grace and said, we have to give and pray and embrace our new priest here, who is in charge from now on. And he, of course, knows that it works for God, as we all do. And we have, as priests, always God looking at our works and our hearts and our thoughts, and he's the one we really work together and you follow it. So I know a lot of young people have said, oh, now we have a priest of our own generation, and God is excellent. I wish more priests, new generation comes, so the oldest will go, move away, pass over, they all the experiences they do have to the new generation. So I welcome you, Father Michael, my son, to this great community and parish of preference. Also, we have part of our parish, the Premier, who is always with us and says, I feel like your parishioners so can come here to come at any time.
And on that note, I would like to invite Stephen Marshall, Donald Premier of South Australia, to say a few words.
To His Grace, Bishop Suwan of St. Pete, Father Stavros, Reverend Fathers, to all of the distinguished guests, Adriana Christopoulos, who's a very hard-working and dedicated member of South Australian Māori Culture and Ethnic Affairs Commission, to all of the faithful parishioners here at Prophet Elias and the broader parishioners and faithful of the Holy Archdiocese, the Greek Orthodox Archdiocese. It is an honour and a privilege and a pleasure to be with you here this evening. Your Grace, thank you for your kind words and prayers for the government during this extraordinarily difficult time. It is a difficult time for South Australia, for Australia and for the whole world coping with the coronavirus, and we're very grateful for your prayers. This is a time when so many people reflect on what is important for them in their lives, they reassess, and I'm so grateful for a parish like Prophet Elias. I've often referred to this as a lighthouse parish, a great leadership parish of Christian churches in Australia. My main reason for coming tonight is to honour the service of a very special man, Father Stavros, who has been a faithful leader, a hard-working leader, a visionary leader for the Greek Orthodox Archdiocese and for our local community. We thank him for this outstanding service. I do this on behalf of the South Australian Parliament, more broadly on behalf of the people of South Australia. Father Stavros, your outstanding, incredible service here is an inspiration. It's a motivation. It's a motivation to your parish. It's been a motivation to me during this very difficult time. Really appreciate your high integrity, your vision, your love of language, as well as the church. You've inspired so many innovations here at Prophet Elias, and we're all the beneficiaries of that. Whenever I come here, I feel very welcome. You've made me feel welcome here for more than a decade. For that, I'll be very grateful. Also grateful for Presbyterian, for her wonderful margarita soup. So I'm not sure this is going to continue. I hope that it is. It is an emotional night tonight as you come towards the end of your service in this parish. It was a wonderful service with your three sons and two daughters, but three sons in the sanctuary here, which is just quite outstanding. And I think that you must feel very proud of your family, you must feel very proud of your broader family in the church. And on behalf of the people of South Australia, I have a small gift to acknowledge the extraordinary service that you've given to this parish and to the broader community.
This is the flame. This is the flame, but also it's got colours in. They're very special. They've got the Greek colours, but also the So it's very nice. It's heavy. It's good to have in your desk. Thank you very much. I really appreciate that. It's excellent. Thank you.
If I can have you all seated, whoever is standing, thank you.